Hey guys, it's That Van Guy, and we're gonna do some stuff today.
So, this is my first fab project. It's got lots of really bad welds, and it's kept me happy for most of the year that I've had the van, but I think it's time to build something new.
So before we dive into this new bumper project, I wanna show you guys my new exhaust because I'm in love with it.
Jake works on his car sometimes.
I do, sometimes. I eventually give up procrastinating and roll around on the shop floor till 2 o'clock in the morning, getting really upset the fact that I decided to build something that you can't actually get any aftermarket support for. And then I get down and look at it, and it makes me really happy, so it's all worth it.
Please, Kyle, too thick for you.
Is that your shameless plug? Add me on Snapchat.
It is a good rock climbing hold. You really want to put emphasis on the heel hold right there.
Oh, yes!
Alright, so I just took the old plasma cutter, whacked off metal brackets so I wouldn't have to make some new ones. No welding to a new bumper that I'm making, eh? It'll be pretty good. I got like 4 grade 8 half inch bolts. Pretty sweet. Blasted these parts so that I can go through and redo all my old crappy welds and get these things back together. So, yeah. Currently, I'm boxing in the bumper plates. Gonna be welding all the way around these and putting a nice piece of flat steel over the top so that I have something flush and clean to attach my new bumper to. Well, it's 2:30 in the morning, got these nice plates all fabbed up. I'm gonna come back in the morning and finish everything up. Hold on real quick. Basically, just wanted a nice surface that I could start to build my new bumper on top of. I wanted something that was gonna look more professional, so. Anywho, made sure they're nice and square and nice looking, so I'm gonna come back in the morning, finish grinding them, do a bit of sandblasting, and start throwing some tubing on.
So next morning, I'm back. Didn't have any troubles with no bumper life. So now I'm gonna head back to the back of the shop and finish up those plates.
I got these plates all finished and cleaned up. Got some measurements marked out, and first piece is a pipe cut. He's gonna sit like that, so the bumper will sit out further, and I can run a light tray back towards the drill. I'm gonna get these welded up, and I'll stick them on the front and show you guys more detail what I'm talking about. So, got the plates all set up how they're gonna be. Now I just need to get some measurements and weld the bar in between the two. And I'll have a nice little tray to set some lights on once I get everything said and done. Okay, so I got the crossbar all tacked up on there, and now I can take it back and bend everything up and finish weld it. I like how it's coming so far. It's nice and level with the front end and ready to have the corner pieces put on. All right, so I just got this piece finished welded. It's looking pretty nice. So it's welded all the way around now. And now I'm gonna sandblast it, mount it back up, and measure for the corner pieces. All right, just got the corner pieces tacked on. I'm just gonna run in below the headlights right there. I'm gonna do the same thing I did to this pipe right here. Fold it over, tap it over, weld it nice. So I'm excited to see how it's gonna look. Looks pretty good right now. You can kind of see where the tray is gonna be. But I like it.
Justin, for working that wrench. Out here helping me today, being a homie.
Got her all fabbed up, corners and all. Just gonna be adding the lower skid plate attachment point as soon as I get back from dinner. I'm getting hungry, so I'm gonna take a break.
Well, Justin had a fantastic idea. Taking pieces of half inch angle iron that I made for clamps, clamp round stuff tables, to mark out each side and notch it, and it made the somewhat confusing job really not confusing at all. So progress update, got the crossbar in, I'm gonna end up running a piece from right here up to the corner over there, just to tie everything together. So it should be pretty sweet. Anyways, that's what's going on. So just got the corner pieces all welded on. Just need to make a backer plate for these guys and get my top sheet for the lights to sit on done, and then some skid plate bars, and then I'll be good to go. Can't wait to see what it looks like. Guys, I'm calling it a night again. I got these backer plates welded on all nice. Cut them out with the plasma cutter so they look ultra sick. I'm gonna mob out to a buddy's house and chill with him for a bit. Just get a break from the shop. Put that lower bar in. Starting to look pretty good. I'll see you guys tomorrow. All right, so we're out here. I got these pipes notched to sit where they need to be on there, nice and flush.
All right, so just got the skid plate mounts welded on there. I'm gonna do a crossbar in between right here and fully sheet this in so there's no way anything can get to the radiator or the AC condenser. As far as that goes, I'm just gonna use 1/8 inch sheet to make sure it's extra burly. And I'm gonna do the same thing for the top plate here. I'm gonna do a cardboard template and make sure I can get the contour of the front end just right. So next time you see the bumper, it'll hopefully be fully bladed in and mounted back up here for a test fit. So skid plate update. Cut this up, plasma cutter, got it welded all the way around. As you can see, my welding skills have got a lot better since I made my first bumper. That's one of the main reasons why I'm making this new bumper, so I can be proud of what I've made. And I ordered 5 new LED lights from SCK Light Bars Official, my new light bar sponsor, to dress up the front of the van a bit. So I needed a new space to put all those, and I figured if I'm gonna go through all the effort to build a light tray, I might as well build a bumper. So there's this. Well, guys and gals, there are more grinding going on in this bumper right here than there is at a high school dance. It's pretty ridiculous. I'll give you a little, I'm using my front face camera, so, or my rear face, whatever you want to call it. The selfie one, to show you guys what's going down. Lots and lots and lots of grinding, nice and smooth edges. So yeah, I don't know what time it is. It's like freaking like 1 something. I'm not actually very tired, but it is very responsible for me to stay up this late. So, I don't know. Van life, I guess. So, I'm gonna keep grinding away at it, and we'll see what happens. Catch up with you guys later. Sorry guys, I look like a mess. Just got done working out down here at the shop with Justin again. And anywho, I gotta go plug my phone in because it's at 11%, so I'm gonna do that. And then once she's all nice and charged up, I'll break the camera out again and give you guys a progress update. Okay, so just got the top plate cut out, plasma cutter, notched out, matched the drill, everything, super fancy. Ran some thick beads all the way across the top and over, so she's solid. Can't wait to see this thing back on the van. So, anywho, that's the update. I'll check in again when we've got paint on there. I'm so excited! So, bumper's there, and now, or bumper's not there, excuse me.
Bumper's over there.
Van is over there. Got that confused. blonde. So, it's paint time. So, I'm gonna be putting paint on this beautiful, magnificent thing. I'm so excited! Ah! I can't wait.
When you get most of your bumper primed up and your sawhorse decides to buckle on you, so you go mad rage status and break it into a million pieces and throw it into the trash. That's what you get for being a piece of crap.
Don't worry about any sawhorses blowing out on me now. Only have to worry about that nice welding wire snapping on me.
is definitely a possibility. But I have some faith. I feel like that's good enough. So. Anywho, that's what she's gonna look like. I'm excited. Perks of painting during the winter time. So I'm literally watching paint dry. Probably one of my least favorite things to do out of the whole project. It's exciting to see the way the bumper is gonna look now that it's all done. I've just been killing some time by editing some of the footy that I've captured over the last like 4 days. It's gotten pretty cold in here because I've been venting all the paint fumes out. And it's a good like 25 degrees outside. So I'm gonna close up the back. I'll show you the bumper really quick. It's right over my shoulder. It's right there, it's looking sick. I can't wait to get it on the van. I'm gonna dust it with one more coat. Even though my first coat was ridiculously heavy. I probably painted for a solid 20 minutes, just stacking coats. So I should probably let it dry for longer, but I'm impatient and I want to get this thing on the van, so I'm going to dust it with another coat. It's already like 2:15 in the morning, and I don't know, I should probably drive home and leave this thing in here to dry for the night. I might end up doing that, and then I can post up some fire pics on the Insta tomorrow, and I'll do a reveal video to leave you guys hanging for now. What the bumper looks like. It is matte black. I decided to go with matte just because it hides little imperfections a little bit better, because there are some. When you get into a project like this, you have to let a little bit go, but I just want it done for now. I can always go back and revisit it. I got the D-ring mounts here. Welded in a different location. I was originally going to do them here. I did them here instead, so there's less leverage on everything. They look good. I'm stoked. They might not be as burly as D-ring mounts you can buy, but we just have those laying around. It's 2 1/8-inch plates welded together, so 1/4-inch total, because I'm good at math. And yeah, I'm excited. I'll talk to you guys later. Thanks for watching. Look out for that new video. It should be dropping here pretty soon. Later.